police, defunding the police, this time to the tune of $10 million. Why? Because they decided to shoot a beanbag at a protester unlawfully. Put a picture up for a mass. This is what happens when you allow lawless cops to remain on your police force. They will bleed your city dry. Leslie Furcron was hit in the face with a beanbag. This is basically a projectile. It is shot at you. This happened May 30th, 2020. They actually agreed to this in 2022, but the council has to now vote on it. So I'm going to give you the background to what happened and why this cop was 100% wrong, but nothing is going to happen. He actually got a promotion. The city of La Mesa settled a civil lawsuit with a 61-year-old woman who has now been left partially blind by an officer shooting a beanbag during a 2020 protest of the killing of George Floyd. Despite receiving an eight-figure award, the woman says her life has been severely altered and no amount of money can replace what she's lost. The city settled a complaint filed on behalf of Leslie by Dante Pride. Dante Pride in the San Diego Superior Court and later forwarded to federal court for $10 million. That's according to San Diego Union Tribune. The lawyer said in the statement, and I quote, "Ms. Leslie suffered horrific life-changing injuries at the hands of the LMPD. I want you to keep this in mind. LMPD. Going to come back up in just a moment. Under circumstances that were criminal at worst and grossly negligent at best. The lawsuit alleged her First Amendment right to protest was violated by the local police detective named Eric Knudson. The officer shot Ms. Leslie during a protest in May 2020 outside of the police department headquarters with a beanbag ammunition. He opened fire on Ms. Leslie because he said he believed she was throwing rocks at other police. The settlement was actually reached in December 2022. However, it is scheduled to be approved by the city council next month. DA Summer Steffen, let's put her up, wrote in a letter to law enforcement, "The officer's actions were reasonable and categorized as self-defense." Self-defense, you say? Did we not just conclude there was nothing to defend against? How is this conclusively self-defense? Well, there's more. It goes like this. Detective Knudson believed Miss Furcron had thrown a rock. That's the DA talking. Now, she's sounding like a defense attorney. There's more. He was incorrect. She threw a can, but his belief was not unreasonable given the totality of circumstances the officers were dealing with over several hours of protesting and rioting where they were subject to rocks being thrown at them continuously. She wrote, before adding, "There was no evidence Detective Knudson intended to aim at her head." The police department also added the officer did not violate department policy. "From an administrative standpoint," it says, "it is determined that this detective reacted reasonably within California law and department policy when he discharged the less lethal shotgun in order to prevent injury to other law enforcement officers." Oh, okay. So he used the beanbag to protect police, not to protect citizens. He would prefer to use the gun, I guess. All right. A report from the department officials said, ironically, the report shows the detective was never properly trained to shoot the firearm that he was in possession of. That's number one. Number two, the gun in question did not belong to the LMPD. Who did it belong to? It belonged to the sheriff's department. Furthermore, the beanbag gun also magically went missing during the investigation into the case. Years after the inquiry, criminal charges, the weapon has not been found. Facing no discipline from the force, this detective was eligible and has now been promoted to the rank of sergeant. So let me highlight a few things here that must be spoken on. Number one, you have the DA, 1-2 combination. DA comes out, oh, nothing to see here, self-defense, even though it wasn't, it is. And then the police department, they come out, oh, no, a policy violation here. The DA says, and we have no evidence that he was aiming at the head of another person. Madam, you know good and damn well that is not the standard of law. If you engage in conduct that is grossly negligent, disregards the reality of cause and effect, there can be a criminal penalty. However, because of statutory dynamics and a few Supreme Court case rulings, the same law that would apply to me will not apply to them. It does not apply to them. Gross negligence typically will not end up in a criminal charge with a cop, but it would with you. All right, hell of a thing. The beanbag wasn't even the department issued. It has magically gone missing. I think the reason it's missing is because it probably may have been enhanced. All right, thoughts, dear brother?
You know, this is why you cannot basically have cops investigating cops, because as much as people don't want to think about it, that is essentially what the district attorney is. These are the people they work with every day on every case that they bring. They're their friends. That's your buddies. You hang out with them after work. You go out for drinks. You go to dinner. These are good friends that will protect each other no matter what. And let's look at her statements here. Like, okay, first of all, he thought she threw a rock. He believed there was a danger. We don't see that there was intent. It's assumption on assumption on assumption that you get so far out there that you're not even close to the truth. You're not even close to analyzing the situation because you're just assuming all of these magical things like, well, clearly he didn't mean to aim it at her head, even though it had to have been aimed at her head in order to hit her in the head. Mm-hmm. So you cannot make that assumption when you have the physical evidence of the beanbag hitting this woman's eye. She was 59 years old at the time. She was not a threat. And if you can't tell the difference between a rock and an empty can of Red Bull, one of the shiniest cans out there, then you don't have the judgment necessary to have a weapon as a police officer.
That's right.
That's my thought on that.
And fair, you know, they were out there just shooting everybody. They didn't give a damn what they were doing. They were just shooting people with beanbag rounds.